Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastahdihu wa nastaghfiruh wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fahuwal muhtad wa man yudlil falan tajida lahu waliyan murshida. Alhamdulillah, ghafirudh dhanbi wa qabilut tawb. شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير اللهم لك الحمد يا من لم تتخذ ولدا ولم يكن لك شريك في الملك ولم يكن لك ولي من الذل والله أكبر كبيرا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد مالك الملك يؤتي الملك من يشاء وينزع الملك ممن يشاء يعز من يشاء ويذل من يشاء بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير سبح له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم له ملك السماوات والأرض يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك شرح الله له صدره ووضع عنه وزره وأعلمه أن مع العسر يسرا أن مع العسر يسرا وأمره أن إذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله وأحذركم ونفسي من عصيانه ومخالفة أمره لزوما لقوله الحق تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وكذلك في قول الحق تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. My dear brothers and sisters, my dearest children, indeed, after 40 days of war against civilians in Gaza, one is unable to deal with his own feelings of anger, helplessness, powerlessness, and one is wondering if there is an end to this genocide that is happening right now against the civilians, including children, including infants, including women, including seniors. And this is a genocide that is done in front of the international community leadership. And it is done with an endorsement, with the full support, with the different war machines, guns, warplanes, bombs, and this what makes the international community so outraged. And when I start saying in front of the international community leaderships, and I said the international community is outraged, I do mean what I'm talking about. Because it's unfortunately the leadership of the international community who have lost the sense of their own morals and principles. and they have lost touch with their own feelings as a human beings who have children, who have family members, who have obligations and responsibility to the other fellows living on this planet that we share all together, that is called the earth. And I do mean and also congratulate the international community for being so conscious and for hitting the streets at different occasions and for demonstrating and showing their outrage, shouting in an anger voice in front of their own officials, enough is enough, cease the fire in Gaza now. How much more we can say until the officials, until the leaderships of the international community would get the message and wake up to the conscience? And it doesn't look like they are willing to do so. So therefore, it's us, the mass. It's us who are having the pain, who needs not to keep their mouths shut, but to continue to demonstrate and to continue to do what it takes for us to be able to make our message crossed clearly and loudly and have the officials to act upon it. Cease the fire now. Enough genocide. Enough killing of innocent civilians. There is no need for these sophisticated weapons to be used in this war. What is needed is to look to the root cause of the 75 struggle of a nation or people in their own country. It is looking into the occupation that has been making the livelihood of the Palestinian so miserable. It is the siege on a small geographical area that has been imposed on them for over 17 years. It is the continuous aggression of the Israeli forces against Palestinians, that the Israeli jails is filled with so many prisoners and political prisoners. That's what the international community need to deal with. We need to apply the international laws. We need to hold accountable those who transgress against the international laws. We need to apply the resolutions of the United Nations so that justice could be served, so that a real solution to the problem will be found. When we continue to play dumb, and when we continue to blind our eyes on what is happening, and when we continue to play double standard, then we will not be able to have justice and peace applied not only in Gaza, but in the international arena all over the world. I know how we feel. I know that we're so frustrated. I know this is having a toll on us when we watch the invasion of hospitals, and when we see the killing of the children and babies, and when we see people coming under from underneath the rebels with injuries, and when there's no enough infrastructure support to help rescue these people from under the rebels, when their homes were bombed, when the schools were bombed, when the hospital were bombed, and when the hospitals would shut down because there is no supply, no more supply to be able to serve those who are injured as a result of this, when hospitals would do surgeries without morphine, when doctors cry in front of the cameras and plead to the whole world and say what we're seeing is unbearable. What we're asking you for is to provide the basic needs for a human to be able to survive And their words seem to be falling on deaf ears. We will not allow the fear. We will not allow the helplessness to creep to our hearts. We will not feel despair. And to our families in Gaza, we say to them what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ali Yasir, sabran Ali Yasir, inna maw'idakum al-jannah. Patience, Ala Yasir, the family of Yasir, radiyallahu anhu, as your final abode is al-jannah. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّا الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says to us in the Quran, Surah Al-Ankabut, do people think that they would claim to be believers and they would let alone without being tested? So the mighty would know who is honest, who is sadiq, who is truthful, and who is a liar. And the ayah speaks to us nowadays, because I never understood who is a liar until I lived the moments we're living in right now. Until I saw mass media corporations lying, promoting the lie, and to continue the lie to lie without having any bit or an atom of conscience in their heart or their mind. We see one of the most powerful regimes on earth with sophisticated war machine lying and continue to lie and to promote the lie without any accountability. And what's even more hurtful is to see the representative of the most powerful nation on earth to adopt these lies and promote them with a very cold heart and mind and ruthless feelings. Because if he were to have a bit of a feeling in his heart and mind, if he were to have an atom of conscience, he would not be allowing a genocide to take place with his full support. With the full approval of the other side to continue doing their war against civilians. And I do stress again, civilians, because the total number of the civilians who have been killed so far is beyond imagination. I can't keep a track. Is it 12,000? Is it more? We are unable to keep track with the number. We're unable to keep track with the number of those who are injured. إن الرجل لا يكذب ويتحرى الكذب حتى يكتب عند الله كذابا. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to us, a man will be lying and continue deliberately to say the lie until he's announced and recognized by the mighty Allah Azza wa Jalla as a liar. So we say to journalists who have moral principles, they have consciousness, they have taken a vow upon themselves to be advocate of truth. We say to them, speak the truth, promote the truth, and act upon the truth. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. And we know, regardless of our faith background, regardless of our cultural background, that lies do not survive. We've seen what were the consequences of the lies of the intelligence services upon the war of Iraq. Weapons of mass destruction reports were promoted throughout the mass media to convince the mass public that we have a threat we need to act upon. The consequences, the result after that, the killing of so many civilians, including innocent children who were murdered in Iraq as a result of the embargo that was imposed on the Iraqi people. Many years afterwards, we hear that these reports were false. We say right now that the reports are promoted about what's happening in Gaza are false. They are big lies. And we are not allowing our own officials to promote these lies anymore or to sell these lies to us. We will stand firm regardless of the consequences and say enough is enough. Enough for the genocide of killing of innocent civilians. No matter what are the consequences for that, we have brothers and sisters of our faith background. We have Jewish brothers and sisters who are demonstrating and risking their own safety and saying clearly and loudly that this genocide needs to be stopped. A ceasefire needs to be called, because regardless of the faith, we're all human beings with one moral and principles and values to believe in. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ أَنْ يَسْبِقُونَ سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ Do the people who have done the sayyi'at, those who have transgressed against the morals and principles of their beliefs, those who have ignored their own principle and moral values, do they think they would let go with their own actions? The Mighty is saying to you, no, سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ, you are wrong. What happened to Fir'aun is documented in the different scripts of the faith backgrounds. It's well known to all of us. No one can deny what happened to Fir'aun, la'natullahi alayhi. No one denies what happened to Ad and Thamud. No one can deny that whatever Fir'aun, la'natullahi alayhi, was promoting, إِنَّهُمْ لَشِرْذِمَةٌ قَلِيلُونَ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَنَا لَغَائِضُونَ وَإِنَّ عَلَيْنَا جَمِيعًا حَذِرُونَ. He used to promote lies and always denounce Musa alayhi salam and kill the children of Bani Israel. يُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَيَسْتَحْيِي نِسَاءَهُمْ. And he used to say, I am the Mighty, I'm so powerful. Allah Azza wa Jal, show him who's the Mighty and who's the powerful. So we say to the officials once again, do not be fooled. You know for fact, and your conscience tell you that what you are promoting is wrong. Stand up for your conscience. Stand up for your moral beliefs. أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ أَنْ يَسْبِقُونَ سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ. You are dealing with the Mighty. The Mighty is so powerful. Allah has given you more time to go back to your conscience. Wake up before it is too late. مَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ أَجَلَ اللَّهِ لَآتٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Whoever is ready to the day of judgment, whoever is ready for the day that is inevitable, whoever is ready for the day that is a fact, to stand between the hands of the mighty Allah Azza wa Jal. من كان ومن جاهد ومن كان يرجو لقاء الله فإن أجل الله لآت. If you firmly believe, it's a matter of time. If you firmly believe, it's only a few moments or years or days, and then you will be eventually between the hands of the mighty. And you are ready for that moment. You are in good shape. من كان يرجو لقاء الله فإن أجل الله لآت وهو السميع العليم. And he is the one who hears and the one who knows. He hears what you utter from your mouth. He hears what you speak about to promote the truth, and he knows what exactly in your heart, because you're dealing with the mighty who knows what's in your heart and closer to you than the jugular vein. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَ فَإِنَّمَا يُجَاهِدُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغْنِيٌّ عَلِ الْعَالَمِينَ. And whoever struggles for the truth, and whoever promotes the truth, and whoever is patient on bearing the consequences of speaking the truth, the mighty is saying to you, you're doing it for yourself, as the mighty is so powerful, he's not in need for your own efforts. He's not in need for your efforts, but it is you who needs to prove to the mighty Allah Azza wa Jal that you are sadiq, you are honest, you are truthful. We say to the moms in Gaza, wallahi, our hearts are with you. Wallahi, I can't find the word to express what you're feeling and how much you're suffering, seeing your own baby in front of your own eyes, leaving the dunya while crying because there is no life support for him or her. Picking up your own baby from the rebels and screaming, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We say to her, Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying to you, وَمَنْ جَاهَدَ فَإِنَّمَا يُجَاهِدُ النَّفْسِهِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَنِيٌّ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. We see to the fathers who've seen their own children killed in front of their own eyes, feeling helpless, powerless, unable to protect them and provide safety for them, as we do for our own children every day as we take them to bed and hug them and kiss them and tuck them in their bed, and say to them, good night, say your idhkar so you can wake up tomorrow morning for your school. The father in Gaza, unable to provide that for his own children because there is no home for them to live under or to live in, because there is no guarantee for him to be able to provide safety for his own children. After all, he's unable to provide for them not only food for dinner, he's unable to provide for them clean water to drink. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَ فَإِنَّمَا يُجَاهِدُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَنِيٌّ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَنُكَفِّرَنَّ عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَحْسَنَ الَّذِي كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And those who believed and did righteous, Allah will forgive their sins, and he, the mighty, will be rewarding them with the best of what they have done. In 1 minute, what can I do to be from the sadiqeen? What can I do to be from those who stand for justice and haqq? Number one, your dua. Your dua is so powerful, and do not underestimate it. Let it be with tears from the heart, not from the eyes, to the mighty Allah Azza wa Jalla in the most powerful times of dua, including the last third of the night. Let your money work for promoting the haqq and alleviating the suffering of those who are suffering on earth. Take an action and be active in the political system we live in. We live in a democratic society and democratic government, that advocacy does work. So be a soldier of advocacy against the war, the false war of propaganda. Get involved with a national organization called National Council of Canadian Muslims, NCCM. Visit their website. See what they offer to you on a daily basis to take an action by calling your MP or MPP or calling the councillors or calling the mayor, and see what you can do with your voice to push our government to act justly, to call for a ceasefire, and to call, ask for it now. There is a lot we can do when we translate our negative energy to a positive energy that would motivate us always to do something and not to feel passive. If you're able to get out and participate in these demonstrations peacefully, expressing your voice and sending a strong message to our officials that these demonstrations are not supporting terrorism. They are standing for justice and calling for the end of genocide and saving the souls of civilians. If we all are able to do it, if we all are keeping an eye on what's happening with our children's schools and support them in the propaganda war, or the war of propaganda, then eventually we'll be from the Sadiqeen, who stands for justice and for stands for those who are oppressed all over the globe. وأقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك اللهم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم إن عبيدك أبناء عبيدك أبناء إمائك نواصينا يا رب بيدك ماض يا رب فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاؤك نسألك اللهم بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك بأن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا اللهم اجعله جلاء لهمومنا وأحزاننا يا الله we pray to you as we're in your house as we are in يوم الجمعة as we are in this blessed hour يا الله save the souls of the people of غزة يا رب العالمين يا الله save their souls يا رب العالمين يا الله they have no one to stand for them and protect them except you and you are the mighty. They have given up hope in all the creations of yours and they have turned to you by saying حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ Ya Allah, make us from those who speak the truth. Ya Allah, make us from those who stand for the truth and promote the truth and act upon the truth, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, we ask you to alleviate the suffering of those who are suffering all over the globe, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, wake up the conscience of the leadership of the international community. Ya Allah, be with the masses of the international community who have stood up for justice, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, reward them and bless them for their efforts, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Ya Allah, we pray to you to have rahmah on us and to unite our hearts and to take the love of this dunya from our heart and to replace us with the love of yours, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Allahumma ameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa aqim as-salah.